Today we're playing Tiny Epic Pirates from Gamelin Games. I'm Mark Maya.
And I'm Brittany.
And this is
Board Game Coffee.
Let's do this.
Get back here this instant! Oh.
Thank you. Oh, I love you too. I couldn't have done it without you. Thank you.
All right, now today's playthrough is a prototype of Tiny Epic Pirates. So a lot of the pieces you're going to see here are not in their final format. Actually, except for the cards, I think most of the things are prototype. Like the boats are like 3D printed shapes. The treasure chests are just these red cubes. They're not actually treasure chests at all. And these legendary tokens won't look this good in the end. So I think that's all right, right? But who knows? Maybe we can talk Gamelin into making that happen.
Making some pieces for us?
No, make the legendary tokens us. Right? I think that would work. I don't see why they would say no. We just have to sign off our likeness, right? Isn't that how it works? People just line up around the corner to put our faces on wooden pieces. Okay. So, that is not true. But that would be cool.
It would be cool. But
if anybody wants to put us in a game, let us know. We'll take it. Okay. Anyways, let's continue. So now this isn't a how to play video, but we will talk through our moves so you can follow along. But to start, I'll give you the gist, the rundown of what is happening here loosely. The details will come as we play. Now, the goal of the game is to be the first pirate to bury 3 treasure chests. Now, just because, say if I'm the first player, if I bury 3 treasure chests, Brittany still does get her last ups. And then if she buries 3 treasure chests as well, then it goes down to a tiebreaker situation. The board here, made up of random cards, is our main play area. Brittany is the yellow boat, or ship. I am the red ship. This is the navy, and these two bad boys are the merchant ships, which they're not bad boys at all. They're pretty easy to kill, and they're just full of goodies. Over here, we have the market. This is where you'll trade in your goods. That's what these cubes that we have on our ships are. Those are goods. And each of them are a different color. Brown is coffee, tan is sugarcane, gray is gunpowder, purple, which looks a lot like the brown, is rum. This represents the strengths of our merchant, strengths and rewards of our merchant ships. This is crew. This is the crew line. That's we recruit from there. And you'll see what these are during battle. Oh no. in the final, those are supposed to be actual cannons and not these what looks like little Pepsi cans with no labels on them. Now, this area here, this is your helm. This is where you'll assign your commands to your crew. So this is a rondel. So basically every turn you go down this wheel and each symbol here represents a command you can assign. Crew up, trade, plunder, search, and attack. Every time you pass over, go right around the wheel and cross this red line, that's when the non-player boats move. Down here you have your deckhands. Now these guys, while they're in their assignments, they will award you bonuses. For example, this guy gives you a +1 to your movement, this one +1 to your attack, and this one gives you 1 gold when you pass that ship line. But at any point, you could remove them from here. Not at any point, when you're giving a command, you can remove them, place them on your command wheel, and use them to hop or leapfrog right over to the command that you do want. Because without them, you have to take the one that's available in front of you. And you can only go clockwise. Now this over here is your legendary mat. This will track how much gold you have, a maximum of 13, and it'll also track your legendary status. You start off at Sea Dog, but you can get as high as Dread Pirate. Now, as you go up this list, you will unlock things like gold, crew members, cannons, etc. And you'll also improve the performance of your ship in battle and movement. So if you get all the way to the top, 4 movement and 3 die when attacking. Okay, I think that is the gist of it. We will talk through things. So gameplay will start
now.
All right, welcome to the gameplay section if you've skipped ahead. Okay, so I'm going to go first, and we'll just talk through this and see how this goes.
Okay.
Well, my first move I'm going to do is I'm going to take the first one in front of me, which is crew up, and I'm just going to crew up.
Okay.
So I'm going to move my ship first, and here's how it goes. Your turn goes, you select a command from your helm, you move your ship, then you execute the command you chose at the start of your turn. And then after that, you see if you've triggered any bonuses, and you check if you cross the red line. And bonuses come in the form of, down here, if you notice, like all crew cards, this is your captain. So I have my captain, Brittany has her captain. The captains pretty much do the same thing. They have different artwork on them. And you can choose whatever side you want to start with. Both sides do something different. At some point in the game, we can flip them if you want, but we'll get into that if it happens. Okay. So yeah, these bonuses, if you notice, this is a search action, which matches that. So if I was to take a search action, I would trigger these bonus abilities. So that's how the crew members work. Anyways, so I'm gonna crew up. So first I'm gonna move. Where do I wanna move to? My movement speed is currently 2. 1 because I'm a sea dog currently, and I also get 1 because I have 1 deckhand in rigging. So let's see, I'm going to move, I don't want to move this way because this is a storm, and if you move into a storm, your deckhands get jostled, which means they get knocked over from their assignment areas into this repair space, which means you don't get the bonuses that they offer when they're in those spaces. Okay, but you can't go into a storm unless you have somebody to jostle. So I'm going to go 1, 2, I'm going to go there. And I will crew up. Who am I gonna pick for a crew? I think I might choose this guy. Now this guy here, whenever I perform a plunder action, his bonus will trigger. Now, if I had, if this triggered on a search action, I would have to do the captain's first. So the captain's bonus always triggers before the rest of your crew do. And you can have up to 3 of these guys. Oh, sorry, 4 of these guys. 5 in total if you count your captain, but you don't count your captain as part of the crew. He's the captain. He can have 4 additional crewmates with him. Okay, so we're refilling the crew row. I've done my turn, so Brittany, you can go.
So, I am going to plunder, and I have to move 1.
Figure out where you're gonna go.
I'm sorry. Okay, I'm gonna go here.
Okay. So plunder is an action that takes place. It's got the 2 cross swords, and you can see that matching symbol there. If you look on Brittany's card underneath her captain's meeple, you'll see the plunder swords. Those match the icon on this card. So this game is very icon matchy. So like even when I crewed up, the crew up is it's got the same face of that crew member. So Brittany comes over here because there's a plunder symbol and there's a picture of 1 crate. That means she gets to plunder blindly from the bag of cubes 1 random booty. What are you gonna get? What do you got?
I have sugarcane.
Oh, sugarcane. Currently, the value of sugarcane is 4 gold.
Nice.
Nobody has coffee, and coffee is at 5 gold.
Okay, so none of my bonuses trigger. So it is your turn.
Okay. I think I'm going to skip the trade phase because right now all I have is rum and rum is valued at 2. So I don't really want to trade rum right now. Mm-hmm. Oh, and the thing about the trading is when you do trade, you actually lower the value of what you traded. Unless it's at the bottom, it can't lower anymore. And when something goes down, everything else goes up. All right, so I'm putting a deckhand on top of my trade area, so it allows me to skip right to plunder. So I'm gonna do that. Now if I didn't use my deckhand, I'd have to stop on trade. And I can use more. Now the only rule for jumping around the board and skipping ahead is even if you have enough deckhands, you can't skip all around your board and end up on the same space you started on. So you can't have, basically you can't have the same turn twice.
That makes sense.
Okay, so I'm plundering. I am going to... You know what? It's going to get risky. I'm going to dive into the storm. I'm going to sail into the storm. One, two. Now, as you can tell, this is a storm area. You can tell by the storm clouds. Now, when you go into a storm, I have to jostle. My ship gets jostled, so my crew members have to go into repair. At least one crew member does. And they have to be sent to repair from your deck assignment. So I couldn't send that guy to repair. So I think I'm going to send in my rigging guy. So my ship is now slower because he's in the repair station. Okay, so now that I've moved there, and the reason I did that is, if you've noticed, Brittany plundered for one crate. In the storm areas, although they do impede you and kind of like weaken your ship, there is advantages for going into the storm. Mainly, plunder awards you with two crates instead of one, and to bury a treasure chest, it only costs 12 gold, where everywhere else, it costs 13 gold. So that's why we're collecting gold, by the way. Once we have enough gold, we stuff it in a treasure chest and we can bury it in a hole, like a good pirate. All right, so I'm plundering. Let's see what I got here. Bam. Ooh, two coffee.
Nice.
Not bad. So I've got two coffee and a rum. Now, I'm not sure how it looks on camera, but the coffee and the rum look very similar.
So these are two coffee and
the rum. Yeah, the middle one's a rum, right? Because they look very similar. In the prototype, the colors are very close. So there'll be a little more difference in the final version. Okay, so that is it. I have plundered. Oh!
Huh?
I forgot.
Yes?
I have a plunder bonus.
Oh.
So, but my plunder bonus is to bury your treasure chest. Now, to bury a treasure chest, you have to... two things have to be in place. First of all, you have to be on a map tile that allows you to bury a treasure chest, which I am. And you have to be able to meet the cost of it, which on this tile, it says 12 gold. I have 1 gold, so I'm far from doing that. And that's the only way you can bury treasure, is if an ability triggers that allows you to bury treasure. You can't just walk over and be like, or sail over and dig a hole. Mm-hmm. All right, you're up.
Okay.
Sorry for the interruption.
Okay, so I am going to use my deck hands, and I'm going to place this here and here, and I'm going to jump over to...
So what did you skip there? Trading and attacking? You don't want to trade or attack, eh?
You're correct.
I'm okay with that, because usually she attacks me, so I'm all right with that.
So, I'm going to recruit this guy, and... He allows me to re-roll either the 3 or 4 when I roll them. Yeah. So okay. That's cool.
And that's
during battle.
Not during battle. When you perform an attack command.
Ah.
So if you're defending, you don't do that. Remember, the bonuses only trigger when you trigger that command.
I see. Okay.
Okay. Now, normally bonuses happened at the end of, like, there's a certain section where bonuses happen, but rerolls will happen, like, your reroll will happen during your attack. Because it'd be pointless if it happened after your attack goes over.
Makes sense.
Okay. My go. I'm going...
Oh, and I didn't want to move.
Oh, you stayed still, did you?
I stayed still.
All right. I'm going to search... So I'm going to leave, because if I stay in the stormy area, I get jostled again. So if you enter or stay, you get jostled. Leaving doesn't do any damage. So let's go here. I'm just going to go one space. I could only go one space, actually. No, good call. Forgot. And I'm going to search. Searching means I get to flip one of these tokens over. Oh, and I got a Surefire token. Nice. So this means I get one of those cannons right away. And right now those cannons, they're supposed to look like this, but they don't. They look like this. So let's put there. I can hold 3 of those. Now what's good about the Surefire tokens is when you get these and you roll to attack, if a die doesn't come up a face you like, it's better than a reroll. You get to spend a Surefire token and change that die face to anything you want, which is beneficial. Let me give you a quick rundown on how attacking works. Say if I was to roll, let's say that. Say if that was my roll. I rolled a 2 and a 6. Now, the way attacking works is you score per matches on your crew cards. So how many crew cards have two? Or how many times does two appear on my crew cards? Once on the captain. How many times does six appear? None. So I've only scored one hit based on this combination. Now, if I spent a Surefire token, I could flip the six, which gets me no points at all, to a three. Where's three? There you go, to a three. Now, three gets me one, two, three hits on its own. So this together would score me four hits. So that's pretty good. Oh, and I would also get plus one from my cannons because I happen to have a deckhand in the cannon bonus. So...
So does anything trigger?
I searched. That's right. I searched so I can bury a treasure again. I couldn't bury treasure in this area anyways because there's no treasure chest in this zone. Because you can only bury treasure where there's the treasure icon. But I'd also only have one coin. Can't bury one coin. And then I also get to plunder, which there's no plundering in this area. I should have planned that ahead.
Yeah.
Yeah. See, things with your bonuses, if I went to go search in an area where I could plunder, then I could plunder, after my search, I'd get a free plunder action, which is, that would have been handy.
Mm-hmm.
But oh well.
Mm-hmm. So I am going to search, and I'm actually going to stay still.
Again. You're just going to
build
a nice place there?
It's really nice outside today. Okay, so I'm going to stay here. And I'm gonna search. And I get, this did not work out in my favor. It did, but it didn't. So, I get to, get a booty.
What's wrong, you get a?
I know, but then I also then trigger my plunder, which was my plan for being in that spot.
Get your booty.
So.
And get rid of that token. You're done with that token.
I am.
Pass me that token for a second.
There you go.
Actually, you want to show the people?
Sure.
So the way that, if you notice, that token says now. So when it says now, you gain that bonus instantly, right away. If it says later, then you could use it. Later ones are usually like movement bonuses. So you can use them whenever you want.
Mm-hmm.
So what did you get?
So I got rum.
So you got two rum and a sugar cane.
Two rum and a sugar cane. Now, because I searched, and my captain triggers, I can't bury any gold, but I can plunder. And I'm in a spot that can plunder right here. So the advantage to this, I guess, in my favor is I get to pick a random one. And then if I want to keep it, I can switch it out.
But I can't keep
them all.
You can only have three crates of plunder on your ship. So
it worked in my favor.
So Brittany gets to trade.
So I got a rum, which now I'm going to trade out my sugar cane. I'm going to give that to you. And I'm going to have a boat full of rum.
Okay. You know what that means. Somebody's going to sink. All right. Let's do this.
Okay. Here we go. All
right. My next action is going to be attack. And I am going to... I can move only one space. Who's one space away from me that I can attack? It's going to be Brittany. Toot toot. Goes my pirate tugboat. Okay, so I'm gonna attack. Currently, at both of our legendary statuses, we're only rolling two die, as you can tell by here. Until my legendary status reaches here, I'm rolling with two die. Once it reaches there, I can roll with three. So there is my two die that I'll be rolling. And the way attack works is I have to settle on what my dice are, and once that's done, Brittany gets to defend.
Defend.
Two ones. Okay, we'll check this out. So two ones gets me two hits automatically because my captain has a one. And I have cannons, so that gives me plus one. So I have a three sitting here. Two natural plus my bonus. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the Surefire token. I'm going to change one of these ones to a three, just like my example. Now that one die is worth 1, 2, 3 points.
So you hit me with four.
No, four natural plus my cannon bonus. Five.
Fine.
So
fine.
Now you see if you can defend five. Ooh, a four and a one. Does that work for you?
It does. So I have one, which scores on this card,
mm-hmm.
And four. Oh, it doesn't work for me.
Oh, he's on the bottom. That's not the top.
So it's not a bonus.
Oh, no, but he lets you re-roll a four.
But I thought that was only if
I was attacking. Oh, when you attack. When you attack, sorry.
Yeah, that's what right. I thought too. So I was like, it works. It doesn't. You failed me, crew member. That's okay, right. So I've only hit with one and one cannon. So I've hit you for two. So I lost.
Yeah, so it's whoever gets the largest attack is the winner. Now, here's the thing. Let's show you what happens to the winner. The winner goes up once on their legendary track. And this says, I gain 2 gold right away. And now my movement is increased to 2, which is excellent.
Yeah, it's nice.
And for the loser, Brittany gets a Surefire token, which is actually really handy because Surefire tokens, that's how I won that battle.
Yeah.
That changed my attack of natural 2 to a natural 4, which mm-hmm. was pretty good.
Yeah.
So, and when I say natural, I mean without the bonuses applied. So here's the thing though. If I attacked Brittany, but Brittany scored more hits than I did, then she would go up her legendary track. So it's a little risky going to attack people. Mm-hmm. So, but it worked out for me. Not completely surprised, right? You kind of expected that to happen. And that's it for me.
I'm crushing him recently. So no. He needs this.
Not yesterday's. It's okay. Not yesterday's game. Okay, let's do this.
Okay. So, do we want to talk about this area on yours?
Oh, the hideout. Sure. The hideout, that's this little anchor here. Now, one thing to note is when you start the game, the players take turns placing their boats on an area that's marked with these anchors. There's one right there. I don't know if you can see that on camera. But that's your starting zones. Those are coves. Now, the hideout action allows you to hide your ship in a cove, so if you can reach one. Actually, there's one right next door to where we are. So, here's what you can do on a hideout action. You could hide your ship in a cove. That means that it cannot be attacked by the Navy or other players, which is a bonus. Mm-hmm. You also get to reassign all your deckhands to any space, to any of the deck assignments that you want. So it lets you kind of have, it's like one of those management meetings you have at work. You're like, okay, where are we going to put Stacy? Is she going to be at the desk? And is Jeff going to get sandwiches? Like, what's going to happen? What is everybody's duties?
It's not even remotely the same.
That's all we do at work. We just get sandwiches instead of desks.
And one thing you didn't mention is that you can skip over that. Oh, so it's the correct. Only place on the card that you don't need a deckhand.
That's right. Yeah, that space you can freely jump over. So you don't have to take that one in front of you.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so I am going to skip this area and I'm going to jump over to Plunder. Now, I just want to make note that I've now crossed this red line and we'll get back to that in just a second. So I'm going to move.
Finally. I thought you had some beachfront property here. Your boat was like parked here since the beginning of the game.
Actually?
Are you not going to stay? Fine.
Oh no, I can't plunder.
Why not?
I'd be crazy to plunder. I'm full.
Yes, you would be full.
So, let me just go back a second.
You going to rewind?
I'm going to rewind.
We'll allow it.
I'm going to rewind. I'm going to use this guy. And I put this on my plunder. And I'm going to jump over to crew.
So you went out to crew? Okay, so now here's the thing. Brittany placed one new deckhand. The other two were there from a previous turn. So if she either lands on them or jumps over them, she gets to assign them back to their deck assignments. There you go. Now, she couldn't use them this turn to advance all around the wheel anymore, but they're back in assignments so they can do their bonuses again.
Mm-hmm. Awesome. So, I'm going to pick a crew member. Actually, I'm going to spend a coin. And I'm going to reset those.
Okay, so for one coin, once a turn, you can take all the crew cards that are showing in the crew row and replace them with 3 new cards. So, at the low, low cost of one coin. There you go.
Okay.
There's better options there.
I do. I'm going to grab this crew member.
The creepy looking. Is that a guy or a girl? I can't tell from here.
It's a guy, I think.
It's creepy looking.
And this symbol allows me to
exchange
out of the bag and take one of my choice.
You get to, if you trigger his special ability, or her special ability, that pirate's special ability, you get to take a booty crate from your ship and exchange it for anyone you want from the bag. Which is pretty good. Like, I could do that right now and get rid of that rum and get another coffee.
There you go.
If I had that, which I don't.
One thing I forgot to do before I picked up my crew member was move.
So go ahead, move now. We'll allow it.
Sorry.
So yeah, when you choose your commands, you're supposed to select your commands. You don't execute them. You select your commands, then you move, then you execute them.
Yes, that was my bad. Okay, so I picked up a new crew member, but I've crossed the red line. So now we have to deal with that.
Now,
and I have a guy in my extort now. Okay. So you might want to explain that.
All right, we're going to use Brittany's card here as an example. So now, as Brittany mentioned, her ship line that she passed. When she passes that ship line, after she completes her move, she'll get one coin for every deckhand that she has in the extort space. She has one. So she'll get one coin for having him there. Excellent. You can tell that by the deckhand. If you look at it as a deck assignment, it has that little circle with the arrow on it. No, that on the deckhand. There you go. Boom. And it matches the one that's in the ship line. That's in the middle of your helm. Excellent. Now that that's done, we get to move the ships. This is when the non-player ships move. And since there's only two of us, it's supposed to be the player to your right that moves the ship. But we're to each other's right. Mm-hmm. So in the order, you move the ships in the order listed on the ship line. So first the orange merchant ship, then the black one, then the navy ship. Okay, they're actually numbered. They say 1, 2, 3 on them. Okay, so here's how the merchant ships move. These wooden discs here are ports. This ship is pointed to this port. That means this merchant ship is trying to get to this port. So he stays pointed toward that port until they arrive. Same thing for the black ship, except it's pointing to that port. So every move I do, I can choose which, if it goes on that tile or that tile, because either way it's getting closer. I just have to make sure it keeps getting closer to that port. So first I move the orange ship, and I'm going to move them up. And I'll move the black ship in this direction. Now, there are storms, but the merchant ships and the non-player ships aren't affected by storms. So now the navy. Now the navy ship moves. Oh, here's the thing I want to say about the merchant ships. They only move one space when they advance. But on the market card, there's a misprint in this prototype where it says they move two spaces, but they actually only move one. So in the final, that'll say 1 and 1. So now moving the navy ship. Now the navy ship moves based on whose player's turn, which player's turn it is. It's always going to move toward that player. So is Brittany. So Brittany is the Navy's target. It's going to try to reach her, and I get to choose the path it takes. And as long as every space I move is getting closer to Brittany. There's actually no reason for me not to want it to get close to Brittany. But it moves at the speed of the number of treasure chests you buried. So since Brittany has buried no treasure chests, it moves two spaces. By the time she buries like two, it moves four spaces. And so on, you can see by the track there. So two spaces toward Brittany. It's going to go 1, 2. So I can't get to Brittany, but I'm trying. Or they're trying. Not me, that's not me. I wouldn't do that to you.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. My go. I could hide out. Or I could crew up. You know what? I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to take my crewmate, or my, sorry, deckmate, from repair, and I'm going to put him on top of crew up. So I get to skip that space for free, and I land right on here, which is my trade. So the deckhand that was there already, I just move him, and I can assign him to where I want. And let's say I want to put him on, hold on, I might want to put him on rigging. Where am I? Yes, I'm going to put him on rigging. Okay, so I'm going to trade, and I put him on rigging. So my movement is... Oh, my movement is 3. I forgot I went up in legendary status. I forgot I was a legend. Silly me.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, where or where is the coffee trade areas?
There's one there. Coffee here.
Where's the other? There's two of every trade zone. Now, here's the thing about trading. Trading posts are indicated by these hands. And you can see them here.
There's the other coffee one.
So, but each trading zone only trades in one commodity. Actually, it matches also the roof, too. You notice the rum is purple roofs on the houses? And the coffee's got brown roofs on the houses.
Oh!
So...
attention to detail.
So you see the little coffee beans, and I have two crates of coffee, so I want to try to get to that trading post, because I can't trade coffee at a rum trading post. Okay, so I can move three. So let's go one, two, three.
Nice.
Nice. If I didn't put that one deckmate on rigging, I wouldn't be able to reach it there this turn. So, since I'm here, I'm going to cash in my two coffees. And you can cash in up to three booty of the same type at one trading post. So, my middle one, although it might look brown, it's purple. So I'm going to trade in these two brown ones, put them back in the bag, and I get 5 gold per coffee I traded in. So that gives me a total of 10 gold, which maxes my gold out at 13. So that works out nicely. But now the gold drops down, everything else goes up. So now coffee is now worth only 2 gold per crate. Okay, so that was my trade. I passed over the ship line. I have nobody in extort, so I do not get a coin. But the orange, black, and navy ship gets to move. Go Brit.
Okay.
Move the ships.
Yes. So I'm just going to think through my turn for a second because I can only move once as of right now, which means I'm limited to the spaces that I can go. My next option...
You mean you're limited to one space.
I'm limited to one space. Sorry. One space where I could adventure out to. I can't really battle because there's a navy... on that ship, and I also can't get to it.
You can. The Navy ship has no impact on you fighting that merchant ship. It doesn't stop you.
I thought if I went into that area, it would.
No, the Navy ship only attacks you if it moves into your space.
Ah, okay. Good to know. I can't reach that space anyways, because I can only move once. So...
it's because you're not a legend. Yeah. You're a sea dog.
So if I were to trade, I only currently have... rum. So I'm in a little bit of a pickle because rum is over here, unless
you're pickled because of all the rum.
I search my next turn and I use my bonus as a plunder to try to get a different
where is this going trade with the merchant ships?
Pardon?
You haven't moved the merchant ships. I'm wondering where this,
because I'm trying to figure out your plan. Because if I have to move towards something and I'm close to maybe trading, I'm just trying to figure out what to do.
Move the merchant ships.
Oh, for you?
Yeah.
Because you moved past Red.
That's right. That's what I've been waiting for this whole time.
That was my turn.
I was like, what kind of master plan are you working on here?
I was working through my... Sorry, I was already on to my turn.
Okay.
Never mind.
Let's move the ships.
Ah, well, this works in my favor.
Orange, black, and then the navy. In that order.
Okay, so orange.
Careful with those masts. They are very fragile.
Black. One, two.
Okay, so the navy ship is moving 2 spaces toward me.
Yes.
Okay. Now it is your turn.
Oh my gosh. How embarrassing. Okay, so scratch what I said earlier. So I'm going to use my deck hands and I'm going to move 1, 2, 3, 4 to battle.
Don't forget to move that deckhand that was already placed there.
Thank you.
No problem.
And I'm going to pop it.
Extort's a good idea.
Yeah, because I just crossed the red.
And
that's
correct. You're going to get a coin.
I'm going to get a coin for that. Good on you. Okay, so now I get to move. So I'm going to move. Oh no, I'm going to lose it again. Because I'm going to go in here. That's okay. I'll lose the coin.
So you're not losing a coin.
Well, I'm not losing a coin. I just won't gain the bonus of that coin.
So she's,
for being in that area.
Brittany went into a stormy area, as you can tell by the dark clouds. So her boat, her ship got jostled.
Yes.
And she chose to sacrifice her coin-gaining deckhand.
Yes.
Go for it.
Okay.
Oh, because you're going to attack that. You want to attack the merchant ship, I see.
Correct.
We haven't done that yet. This is our first merchant ship attack. Now, let me explain how this works. Mm. The merchant ships, they don't roll, right? They don't roll dice. What they do is, if you look at the black merchant ship, it's got an attack of 2. So Brittany has to roll an attack higher than 2 to sink the merchant ship, get its loot. And she'll also get 2 coins. She does not go up on the legendary status because this is a wee baby merchant ship. When the merchant ships get bigger, she'll go up in legendary status, but it will indicate that on the card.
On the card. Yep. Okay, so I'm going to attack the black ship.
Do it. Fail. Fail. 5 and 4s. Oh, you really got easy. Got 2 5s over there on that.
Yeah, so
card.
I have 2 5s, so I hit. Oh. Let me move this over here so you can see it better. So my 5 hits twice, and my 4, I can reroll.
You don't need to.
Why? Well, I guess I hit for 3, so I've already killed it.
Because, yeah, you already have the
it's overkill.
2 from the 5, and you get the 1 bonus from your cannons, right?
Yeah.
So you're hitting him for 3.
Correct.
So, yeah, Brittany
Which
could...
Which was enough.
She could reroll, but there's no point.
Okay. Reroll it. So I...
So here's how this works. Brittany's going to earn 2 coins... For killing that merchant ship?
Yep.
Then we're going to sink this merchant ship. She's going to get the... Do you want the gunpowder? No. So if she wanted, she could take this gunpowder and trade out one of her rums. So gunpowder goes back in the bag. Merchant ship gets sunk. And now this merchant ship gets placed back at a port, but it's the port that's furthest away from Brittany because she's the one that sunk it. So that's the port that's furthest away. So now it's here, it's pointing toward this one. So both merchant ships are headed in the same direction. Now we take this ship card, we'll discard it, and we'll flip out this one. As you can see, they're still the same level. The next Navy ship we kill, you'll see they will get stronger. Mm-hmm. Okay. Oh. So you good?
So I crossed the red line.
Oh yeah, you did. You crossed the red line. So you have nobody on extort, so that's not going to give you any bonuses. But I get to move the orange, the black, and the Navy ship. Now, as a professional ship mover, should I go over my entire turn first and then
move? Don't make fun of me. I'm so embarrassed that I did that. I was so focused on my turn.
I'm putting the orange one in the storm, putting this one over here too, and the Navy ship.
You didn't fill this.
Oh, I didn't. Don't forget to fill your merchant ships when they rise back from the dead.
Professional ship mover.
There you go. Don't mock me. So he's got coffee on him, by the way. Is that coffee or rum?
It's coffee.
It's hard to see in this lighting.
It is.
Okay. I'm looking forward to getting the final pieces. Okay, so the Navy ship is going to move 2 spaces toward you, but it doesn't need 2. It only needs 1. Now here's the thing. When the Navy ship attacks, there's no defending against the Navy ship. You automatically lose. And normally when you lose, you get one of these cannons as a pity prize, but not here. So all you do is the Navy ship takes all their deckhands on your card and puts them all into repair.
Whoopsies.
There you go. Yeah, they got hurt bad. They all fallen over and everything. Okay, so that's what they do. It's not actually all that terrible.
No.
It depends what your future plans are.
Yeah.
Like if you needed them for movement and he took away your movement, that's annoying. Okay, so you crossed the red line, so we're done with you. Now it is my go. I am going to plunder. So I'm going to move my captain. He's going to plunder. But where to plunder? Where to plunder? Oh, I know. Check it. I am going to go, right next door, actually. I'm going to go into the storm. Why am I going into the storm? As I mentioned before, plundering, I get 2 crates if I plunder in a storm. And then you'll see why else. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to plunder in the store. Plunder in the store. Two crates. Bam! Two coffee again! I just pocket those. I just keep doing the same thing. Mind you, coffee...
If you had long sleeves,
first of all,
would be...
In the first go, yeah, maybe it was a cheat. But coffee's worth 2 gold right now. It's the cheapest... it's the cheapest form of booty.
All I hear is excuses, don't you?
Okay, so I did my plunder. Now I check out my plunder bonuses.
Oh.
What?
It's not all coffee.
No,
that's rum.
No, it's, yeah, I know it was rum.
Oh, if I thought you said it was all coffee.
No, I drew...
My bad.
I've only drawn coffee. If it was coffee, I would have traded it last time I traded coffee in.
Fine.
Anyways.
Sorry.
So since I got... Since I plundered, Captain Bonus doesn't trigger, but this bonus triggers, because that's a bonus, a plunder bonus, and that says I get to bury a treasure. So I'm in a treasure bury spot that only costs 12 gold. I have 13 gold. So I also get a discount for burying treasure in a stormy area. So I move my gold down to 1, take a treasure chest off my card, and place it there. Now, you can't bury a treasure where if there, a treasure is already buried there, so that's why covering the symbol is fine. And you can't bury a treasure on a card that has a navy ship on it. Okay, so I plundered, I did my bonus, I'm kicking ass, it is your go. Continue doing whatever it is you're doing.
Okay, so I still don't have enough moves to get to where I want to go with
you. Still have just one movement?
Listen, I don't need your judgment. I am just at one movement, so I'm a little bit limited on... what I can do at this moment. So what I think I might do is I can pull these guys out of repair and put it on my wheel.
You can put it on your wheel, yes.
Yeah.
Not on your assignment.
No. So I am going to...
I thought you were like, oh, I'm just going to take them from repair and put them in movement.
No. So I have to move because I got to get out of the storm.
Hold on. Where's your command?
Oh, I'm going to move over to
crew up.
And then I'm going to move here.
One big old space.
Yep. And then I'm going to crew up. So I'm actually going to take this guy. And I'm going to place him right here. So he's interesting because he actually has no dice. But this allows me to have one successful hit when I'm either defending or when I'm hitting. Right? Or is that defending as well?
It's defending as well.
Okay.
Any crew member with that cannon automatically adds that number to your total. So he's automatically going to add 1 to your total.
Great.
When you
okay.
either attack or defend.
And then his bonus is when I'm hiding, I get 2 coin.
Now, here's the thing. If you take the hideout action, you don't specifically have to hide.
You could just take the action.
Yeah, as long as you take the action, and even if you don't perform it, as long as your captain says, this is the action we're doing... Mm-hmm. You can go through the phases, get to that point where you execute the action, not execute it, but still trigger your bonuses.
Mm. Okay. Okay, so that is my turn.
Okay.
Your go.
Okay, let's see what we're going to do. I'm going to search. No, I'm not going to search. I'm going to check it out. Check it out, Britt. We're going to do some big moves. Ready? Some big moves. Oh, no, I can't. Take that back. These are small moves. I'm going to do small moves. I forgot. If I take my rigging off of here, I lose a movement. So we're not going to do that. I'm going to move over to search, and I'm going to search. So I can move. Currently, I can move 3 spaces. So
must be nice. Now you're just bragging.
I go 1, 2, 3, and I'm going to search right here. I get to move through storms for free. At least once.
That's nice.
So that icon there, there's one of the later ones. So I will hold this until I use it. And that means I can, when I reach one of the stormy areas, I can just sail through and not take damage through 1 card. Okay, so that was my search action. Oh, my bonus. I can bury treasure, which I don't have enough money for, and I can plunder. I did it again. I always forget. If I searched there, I would have gotten the plunder bonus. Oh, every time. Oh, my boat's full anyways. It doesn't matter.
Okay. So I feel like I'm in a little bit of a pickle because the things that I want to do right now, I still can't get there because I can only move 1. So I think...
We forgot to fill this.
Oh.
Ale.
I think the best choice that I have right now is to, I guess, search. So I'm gonna move there, I'm gonna go here, and I'm gonna search.
Flip that token.
And I get 3 coins.
Ooh, 3 coins, that's pretty good.
That worked, that was nice.
So toss that token.
And I go up 1, 2, 3.
Hide it behind the box here. Okay, all right.
Oh, but I search, so my bonuses trigger. So I can either bury, which I can't right now, bury treasure. I can plunder, which I can't right now. And then I can also switch a trade or a booty. So I think I'm going to do that. I'm going to change that to sugarcane.
What are you taking out of your boat there, Chica?
I'm going to take out one of these rums.
All right. Oh, and you get to pick.
And I get to pick what I want because that's his ability.
Sure. I'll get it for you. What do you want?
Thank you. I would like sugarcane.
Sugarcane. Bam.
Thank you.
All right. So, I'm going to... So you have... Do you have 2 rums and a sugarcane in there?
Yeah.
I see. I am going to take... What am I going to do, Red? I know. No. You know what? Yeah. I'm taking somebody from rigging, and I place them on my cannons, so I can skip that. I'm also going to skip my crew up, land right on trading. So I went over the ship line. We'll deal with that later. So I land right on trading, and I am going to, I can move 2 spaces. So I'm going to go down here. Oh, is that what I want to do? Is that what I want to do? Yeah. Okay. So I'm going to go down here, and I'm going to trade my rum for 3 gold. Okay, and the strategy in this game, if you're watching, I did this in the very first game we had where Brittany had like a boatload of rum. I had 1 rum, and rum was at like 5 gold. So I went, cashed in my 1 rum just to lower the price of the rum at the market. So all she got was 6 for her 3, where I got 5 for my 1. Anyways, in this case, I got my 3 gold. And that, oh, and then I went over the red line. I have nobody in extort. Oh, hold on. I would have somebody in extort, because this guy, I didn't put him here. He was already there. So I forgot to move that guy. So because I placed this red guy, but I jumped over a character or a deckhand that was already in place, that means I get to place him wherever I wanted. So I forgot to do that. So I'm going to put him to extort, which gives me 1 coin because I passed the red line.
Nice.
I should have done that as soon as I did it to remember, but... And now the ships move. Brittany, move the ships.
Okay, so the first one to move is orange. So I'm going to move the orange one there.
I'll point him toward the port.
And I will move the black ship here.
Alrighty.
And now the navy ship. And the navy ship moves twice for you?
3 times for me because I have 1 treasure buried. It says here that the navy, 1 treasure means the navy ship moves 3 spaces toward me.
Okay. So 1, 2, 3.
You want to do this?
Yeah.
Okay, so he's here. So that means all my deckhands, I get tacked, I get jostled. All my deckhands go into my repair bay. So that is it for the end of my turn.
Good. I am going to put my deckhands there.
On plunder?
On plunder. And I'm going to go 1, 2, 3 on battle. And I'm going to...
You mean attack?
Sorry. Yes. Attack. My bad. Attack. So I'm going to attack the black ship.
So you're not moving?
I'm not going to move.
Okay.
Yeah.
You think you can take the black ship?
Yes.
Do it. See what you got. You got no cannon bonuses, right? But you do have a surefire token.
Yes.
Okay.
Double fives.
Ooh, that's easily enough.
That's easily a four.
That's four just from that. You don't have to do the rest of the math. It's at least four.
For right here.
Yeah, so that's plenty.
And actually, it's five because he hits.
Gotcha. So you do that have plenty. You do have a bonus.
I do have a bonus, yeah.
All right, so you got
plenty. Okay, so.
So this guy sinks.
Yep.
Do you want the coffee that he was carrying?
No.
Okay, so you're just killing these guys out of spite. You haven't taken anything that they want.
Well, get out of my way.
Okay, so we'll put that in there. You get your two coins for sinking the black ship. We'll get rid of that card. And now look at this. Ready? Ready for this? Bam! Now, the black ship is four power. It gives you four coins when you sink it. And it'll up your legendary status.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I didn't cheat. These cards are actually placed in order. You place them 2, 4, 6, 8. So the last ones are level 8 ships, as you can see here. Yeah, so that's a level 8 ship. That's what the last final ships look like. Okay, so that was it for you. You didn't pass. Oh, you did pass the line.
I did pass the line, yep.
You have nobody in extort?
I do not.
Okay, so the ships are going to move. This guy's going to move this way. This guy's going to move this way. And the Navy ship moves 2 spaces toward you?
Correct.
Oh, you didn't. You don't have any treasure, so it only moves 2 spaces and not 3.
Correct.
It clearly recognizes me as the threat.
It's true.
Okay. You know, I realized I jumped all the way to trade, but what I wanted to do was crew up. Oh, well. It's done. It's done. Actually, you know what? No. What's done is not done. I'm gonna do that right now. I'm gonna crew up right now. I'm going to use all my deckhands and go wee boop and true that again. I don't know if that was a good move, but I wanted to get this guy.
That's what I was going to get.
Yeah. So the reason I got this guy, let me tell you a little story about this buddy here with the glasses.
Me likey.
Is Brittany has won 2 games, or at least, no, 1 game. You won 1
game. I won 2 games with him.
You won 1 game, but you tied me the second time.
Okay.
I would have won, but it was basically this search. When she does a search action, and I say she because Brittany's the only one that's ever gotten this. When she gets a search action, she got 1 coin. So since her search action was attached to her burying her treasure, when she buried her last treasure, because I buried my last treasure and I spent all my coin. She buried her last treasure, spent all her coin, but then got a bonus 1 because it triggered. So that when you end in a tie, first thing you do is legendary status. And usually our legendary status is the same.
Mm-hmm.
Then we go buy gold, and she always has 1 more gold because she always has this guy.
Yeah.
Okay.
Me like him. And now
he's sad. Mine now. I didn't even really want him. I took him because I didn't want you to have him. I did not want
him. Well, you could have just reset.
No, I couldn't. I'm not going to spend my gold to reset. He'd still be in there for you to reach and get at some point.
Fine.
No thanks.
Fine.
Oh, I did it again. I have this bad habit of going to crew up and not moving my ship before I do it. So,
I'll let you move because you let me move.
So I'm going to move. I guess I can move into the storm because I'm moving to the storm and I'll just pull somebody off my wheel. So I'll take him off attack and drop him in repair. So that's how I got jostled. Actually, I don't even have to do that. Actually, I'll do that anyways. I have the free through the storm passage thing. So I'm going to go here with my 2 moves. You know, hang out with these cool cats. That was my crew up move. I passed the red line. I have nobody in extort. So, move the orange, black, and navy ships. Merchants and navy ships.
Okay, so the orange is going to its...
Yeah, the orange port. Will go here, so that means it's going to turn around.
Okay, and then we'll just have the black one move that way.
Okay.
And then now the navy ship goes towards you?
Yeah, 3 spaces. This time it's not going to reach me.
1, 2, 3.
Close, but no cigar.
And I am going to... So I can... You said I can land on this?
If
this
you want.
This is already there?
Yep. So if he's already there, you get to place him at a deck assignment.
Okay. I go here. So that means I can trade now. So I am going to...
Oh, you're taking the trade action? Yes. I got a bit of a glare I can't see from here.
Yeah, so that's a trade action.
Okay.
So I'm going to move here, and I'm going to
What are you going to trade? You got one of each.
I'm not going to go there. I'm going to actually stay here.
You like staying put.
And I'm going to trade...
Sugar cane?
My sugar cane.
Okay.
So sugar cane is at the top, which gives me 5.
I'll take that off your boat for you.
Which means I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I have 13 now.
Okay, so we lower the cost of sugar cane. It is no longer worth 5. It is now worth 2. So there you go. Okie dokie.
And I don't have any trade bonuses, so it's your go.
Excellent. My movement is only 2. So I do not want to trade because I can't reach a trade port that I want. So I will take my deckhand, place him there. Yeah, let's move to plunder. So I'm going to go 1, 2. The one I just placed there stays there, but the previous one that I pass over comes back to me. So I'm going to put him on cannons. Just in case somebody gets cute. No, that's right, I'm looking at you. Mm-hmm. Okay. And I am going to go plunder into a storm. So I'm going to go 1. I'm going to use my free token. Because I have to go to a storm, looks like either way, if I want to go this way. Actually, you know what? Yeah, I can go here. I'll go there. Use my token, which is my first.
Nice.
See if I showed that to you guys. Mm-hmm. I have this, which lets me go through a storm space for free. And my movement's 2, so I'll go 2. I'll go here. So, oh, hold on. I don't want to go here because I can't plunder there. I'm going to go here, and I will get jostled there. No. You know what? I'm going there. I'm staying there. That's what I'm doing.
That's your decision?
I'm using my free token to get in there without taking any damage. And I'm going to plunder here because it's a storm, so I can plunder for 2. Even though I only need 1, but it'll increase my odds of getting something I want. All right, let's see what I got. Plunder, plunder, plunder. Bam! More coffee! All I pull is coffee. 2 more coffee. So I'll just toss that in there and toss the other coffee back. Okay. So I plundered. I could bury a treasure if I had enough coin, but I don't. So I'm good. I got no other plunder bonuses triggering. Yet up.
Okay. So I really didn't think my last turn through. Kind of screwed myself a little bit, but that's okay. Oh. It is what it is. So
I'm really bummed about that.
I know. This is not my game today. Okay. I am going to
think about it. Think about it. Just like a pirate.
You know what? I'm gonna curve up.
You can still carry one more.
Nope, I'm not. I'm not.
No,
I'm not gonna do it. I'm not gonna do it.
Search.
I'm gonna search.
Alright.
So now I'm going to move, and I can't move into a spot. If I had gone with my original plan, I would have been able to go here and then search there, but now I...
You didn't move 2 spaces. Oh, you're still a legendary 1?
Yes. It hurts. It hurts. I know.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Flip that token.
Okay.
See what you get.
What do I get?
Hey, 2 coins. Oh,
and
you
I
can't get any coins. Okay.
Okay, so...
Because the search action takes place before the buried treasure bonus, Brittany's full up on 13 coins, so she can't take any more than 13.
Yeah, very frustrating. So I'm going to bury my treasure, so I'm going to spend 13.
And you're going to bury your treasure because your captain's bonus ability triggers? That
yes,
allows her to bury
that's
your treasure.
Correct. Sorry. Yes. Now, it also allows me to plunder... But I can't right now.
Because there's no plunder there.
Exactly.
Yeah, you can't because there's no area to plunder.
Right.
Because there's no innocent villagers for you to take advantage of.
Exactly. Right.
So what's the next thing you're
gonna do? So what it can trigger is I can switch my booty if I want to.
You get 2 rum.
I'm not going to do it.
You're not going to do it?
No.
And that's it for you. Okay, my
yes.
turn. Could go...
to attack town.
What's underneath here?
A search. So you can search or go to attack town. I don't know.
Ah.
Yeah. Hey, this guy doesn't have a crate on him.
Mm.
We forgot to put a crate on this guy.
We'll yes, now. Yes, you did.
Rum.
A rum.
Put it on him. Sorry. He was just floating around with no crate. You call yourself a merchant. So, what to do? Well, I guess I could attack. I could attack him. It could be dangerous. Because he's a four now. So, I'm going to do that. I'm going to attack. So, I'm going to jump over the deckhand that was already there. And I'm going to put him in cannons. So, that way, because I have two deckhands in cannons, now I automatically have two hits before rolling any die, which is nice. So, for my attack action, I'm not going to move. I'm going to stay here and attack the black merchant because he allows me to level up in my legendary status.
Nice.
So, two die. I got to beat four. Okay, so I roll a four and a two. Not ideal. A two gets me one. So far I have three with my bonuses. And that's not enough. Dang. Am I doing something wrong? Oh, no. I don't have a single four. If these guys had a two or somebody else had a four, I didn't get it. Even with my double cannons.
That's sad.
I didn't get it. I think you're so tough. Okay, so since I lost to the merchant ship, it doesn't sink. I get jostled, so one of these cannon guys will have to go and repair. And I get a surefire token as a consolation gift. So I have no bonuses that trigger on attack, so I'm done. That was a sad day.
Mm-hmm. I don't know if I did that move earlier.
What move?
Jostled. When you won.
Oh, well, it's done now.
Yeah.
If you got to cheat to win, you got to cheat to win. I understand. It's a pirate.
I'm still losing.
You got to play like a pirate. Arr. We both got a treasure chest buried.
I needed you to win.
We both have a treasure chest buried. I did not.
You not winning does not help me.
Because you needed the merchant ship to go near you?
Yes.
Oh.
Because I can only move one.
Do something about that.
I can't because all the ships are away from me.
What's your next action? What are you going to do?
Okay. I am going to... Oh my gosh, I can't even get to the trade. This hurts.
It hurts watching you.
This hurts.
You're like, you got this big ship, and you got like one oar. And that's not even how pirate ships work. But that's what you're doing.
Okay. I'm going to use my deck hands. I'm going to place it there.
Did you only place one there? I missed it.
I only placed one.
Okay.
So I think I actually might be able to move. So I'm going to go here. I'm going to go in here. Skip over here. Go to trade. Get this guy back.
Because he's...
Which allows me to rig. Woo! Oh, so now I can move two. I feel like I need a little happy dance. Okay. So I'm going to move one, two. And now I can trade.
Can you trade your rum?
Yeah, my rum. So, that's two. Rum right now is worth three, which means I go up six.
There you go. So we'll adjust the price of rum at the market. It's now worth two. That's pretty good. Okay. My go?
Yes.
Did you pass over the red line this turn? You did.
I did. It's still
nice,
my turn.
Nice try. So extort, you don't have anybody in extort, nope. So no bonuses.
So move the ships.
I move some ships. Bam. Actually move you in there. And this guy moves. You have a treasure chest buried. So he moves three now after you.
And
one, two, three.
Now I can't move again.
Put all your deckhands back in your... Put them back in their hole. Good stuff. Okay. Now it's my turn. So for my next action, I'm actually going to use a deckhand from my cannons. Drop them over there so I can skip my hideout and I'm going to jump all the way to trade. So I put this guy back because he was already there and I'll put I'll return him to extort, so at the end of this turn I'll get a gold coin. But since I'm in trade, I am going to go trade 1, 2. I'm going to trade right here. And I can trade coffee here.
Yeah, coffee's worth a lot.
And coffee's, yeah, but I'll max out. So I have 3 coffees. So I don't have to trade all my coffees, but... I technically don't have to trade all my coffees. But I'll do it anyways.
Yeah, you don't have to.
Yeah, because only 8 is enough. I could keep it for some other time. I could do that. Because, yeah, I'll only trade in 2 coffees. Because that'll give me 8, which will put me at 13. I'll keep 1 coffee on board. So I'll lower this. There you go. Toss my 2 coffees back in the bag. Gotta keep some coffee for the crew. Keep them alert.
Mm-hmm. And did you just cross the red line?
I did, okay. But let me see if any bonuses triggered on my trading. They do not. So I cross the red line. I get 1 coin for... Oh, I get 1 coin for extort, which doesn't matter. That was a silly move for me to put in there. Because I can't take the extra coin. I'm maxed out. Oh, well. In my head, I was like, I'm going to bury treasure. But I can't. Okay.
You can't.
No, I know. I know. I know what I can't do. All right. So now... Move the ships. Orange, black, and navy.
So, orange, black.
And the navy's gonna come here.
Yeah.
Alright, so all my deckhands go back to repair. Just getting a beating from this stupid navy ship. Alright, I'm done. What you got?
I am going to...
Going on a voyage there.
Yes, I am. I use my deck hands and I'm going to go all the way over to battle and I'm going to move here.
Oh, who are you going to attack?
I'm going to attack...
It's either me or the merchant.
The merchant.
Okay.
The black ship.
Do it. You gotta hit him 4.
Yes.
5 and a 6.
Nice. So I hit...
Oh, yeah,
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Okay, so that's plenty.
That is plenty.
So that he is done.
And I get his little...
Finally, you get to take his... Yay. You get his rum. You get 4 coins. The black merchant ship is destroyed.
4.
And now...
And I move up.
Yep, you do.
Which gets you another 2 coins. So then I get another 2.
Yeah. So the merchant ship goes to the... port furthest from you, which is this one down here. Mm-hmm. And I gotta put a cube in it. That went well for you.
I did.
So you went from I'm not doing too good to like, look at you. You can bury a treasure chest now. Coffee. He's got a...
I can't bury a treasure chest because I can't get into a storm area because of my deckhands.
Yeah, you can move, you can go into a, you can pull deckhands off your wheel to go into a storm area.
Oh, right. Okay, cool.
Okay. So now it's my go. You've done all your doings. And I replaced that already. Okay, nobody's touching the orange ship. It's still a level 2.
Maybe you can do it since you're weak. Something you can beat.
Okay. This coming from the person who's been dragging her ass around the ocean all day.
We're not talking about me.
All right. I am going to... search. And I can move... 2 spaces to search. Arr. And I'm going to search. I'm going to go into the storm to search. And since I used a deckhand, because I can't use deckhands from repair to go into storms, but since I used a deckhand to on the wheel, I now have a deckhand to go into the storm. So I'm going to search in the storm. Let's see what I got. Oh, I can 2 bonus moves. So I can use this to just move 2 spaces. Increase my movement. It doesn't give me an extra move, it just increases my movement. Mm-hmm. So I searched, I grabbed that. Now my search triggers, you have to do the captain's abilities in order. So I'm going to do the buried treasure. So it's going to cost me 12 because I'm in a storm. I'm going to bury a treasure right there.
I crossed the red and we didn't move the ships.
Okay, You did. You crossed the red and you didn't move the ships.
So where are you right now in your turn?
You crossed the red this turn? You did.
I did.
Okay, so we're going to backtrack a little bit. So here's what's going to happen. We're going to take... I would have moved this guy in here. This doesn't benefit me any.
Yeah.
I'm going to move this guy over here. And the Navy ship was already in your space, so you would have put all your guys into your repair. Because the Navy ship would have just pwned you. Okay, that's it. We're caught up.
That's it.
We're caught up. No great loss.
No.
Mistakes will happen.
Yes.
Especially when you're hosting at the same time.
Yeah.
Okay. So now, where was I? I just buried a treasure. So I did my search action. I buried a treasure. And now I can plunder based on my captain's card. It's my captain's bonus. If I do a search with my captain, I get to plunder.
Nice.
So, two coffee again? Seems to be all I pull. Bam! A coffee and a sugar cane. That's my first sugar cane. Get in there. He's like, I like sugar with my coffee, so that works out. Now here's the thing you need to know. Because I did plunder, when you get a bonus plunder action, that does not trigger your plunder bonuses. So if I took a plunder from here, that would trigger this. But because it was a bonus trigger, it does not trigger that. So a bonus does not trigger a bonus. Okay, so that was it. Oh, and I get a coin. Because I have this guy.
Oh, nice. I miss you. Crew member. He's a traitor.
Okay, so that is it for me. So I've got two treasures down. You're not far from that same thing either. Okay, let's do this.
My go.
Your go.
Okay. I am going to put my deck hands. I'm going to skip over and go to search. I can now move two. That's right. So if you can move my yellow over to there.
And you're going to get jostled?
I'm going to get jostled. So I take one off or all of them?
No, one. You only take all of them off when the Navy attacks.
The Navy attacks, that's right.
And you're only allowed to take one off your wheel if you had nobody in your deck assignments, which you don't.
Can I go in there then? Yes, because you can take it off the wheel. Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to search. So if you could flip that for me, please.
You get a mystery crate right now.
Coolio.
See what you get.
Sugar cane.
I'll put that in your boat for you, miss.
Thank you. And now, because I'm there and I have 12, I can bury my treasure for 12, because that's what it is on that card over there.
Pass me over your crate, or your treasure chest.
That goes there.
Put that right there.
Now, my next bonus action on my captain is plunder twice.
Oh, this is a good move for you, a good turn for you. It's the same thing I did last turn, isn't it?
So that's rump, and I get to do it
again. Come on, you can't pick two at once?
I could have, but it's less dramatic. Oh, nice.
So you got rum and coffee. Which one do you want?
Are they both?
That's rum and sugarcane.
Okay, I'll make it easier for you. I will actually then go to my next guy and get a bonus.
Oh, you can't skip. You have to complete one before you do the next. What do you want to get rid of?
The coffee.
Okay, you want to get rid of the coffee. So you're keeping the rum.
Yep.
Oops. Yeah, so the way it works is you can't be halfway through one... bonus.
That's fair.
To take care of the other one.
Okay. So now my next bonus is I get to change.
Sure, you want the sugar cane?
I want the sugar cane.
So you want to take the sugar cane out?
No, I want the sugar cane.
Oh, so you want to take a rum and get rid of the sugar cane?
Yeah.
Okay. There you go.
Thank you. And I believe that is my turn.
Okay. Now, what is Mark going to do? Mark is going to go... He's going to skip attack, and he's going to skip crew up, go right to trade. So I did cross the red line, so note of that.
Okay.
I'm going to travel up one space, and I'm going to trade sugarcane.
Oh, you have sugarcane.
I do.
Oh, I didn't notice that.
So I'm going to trade sugarcane at the sugarcane trading
post. Of course you will.
To get 4 gold and lower the cost of sugarcane. So,
story of my life.
There you go.
Darn, I didn't see that you had it. I thought you only had coffee.
Oh. No.
That makes me sad.
Good news, I did increase the cost of my coffee. So, it's not all bad, right? Okay, so I did my trade. I have nobody in extort, so move the ships.
Orange. This guy's coming this way too?
Yep.
Black.
And he's going to be right on my space, and he's going to take all my crewmates away again. Yep. Violent.
A little bit.
He's moving four spaces now when he hunts us. It's a lot.
Oh, yeah.
So he pretty much can get us anywhere, almost anywhere on the board.
On the board.
Unless we're, like, diagonal from him.
Yeah.
Okay.
Michael?
Yep.
Okay, well, I'm a little bit angry. So, I'm going to use my deck hands.
I thought you were a little bit country. Here,
and I'm going to attack. So if you could please move my ship over to you.
You can't attack the Navy ship.
I'm going to attack you. Because I'm angry.
You can try.
I'm angry.
Yep. Okay. Ones. Threes.
Threes, but I can reroll my threes.
Yes, you can. So you get one reroll because of your baldy eye patch guy. Yeah, ones and sixes. That's even better.
Okay, so one, two. Oh.
No, it's not better. Sixes are worse.
One, two, three, four. I hit you for four.
You hit me for four.
Hold on. I forgot about
this. Wait for it.
I forgot about my.
Yeah, you forgot about it. Put it over there. Don't give it to
What's
me.
What's it called?
It's called a surefire token.
My surefire?
Surefire.
Fire. And I'm going to change that to a five. So, I hit you for five.
So you hit me for, so you have.
So, how many, one,
how
two.
Many, how many times does your five hit?
Twice.
And your six hits twice?
Yes.
Okay. Just making sure. And then you got your bonus one. Okay, so five. That just has to be five? Please. Please. Not a problem.
Nothing.
I'm just going to get a three and just crush
Ones.
It.
Ones.
Boom. Six and a four. That's not good. I don't have a six or a four.
Excellent.
Hold on. Not excellent yet. I don't have a six or a four. Like, this is terrible. Look at this. That's like, I think those are the only two numbers. That's the worst roll I could have possibly gotten. Now, I could change this to a three, but that would get me 4 points only. You have five?
Yeah.
Yeah, four is not going to do it, and I have nowhere else to get me an additional surefire cannon. So, I can't get jostled any more than I already am. You go up your legendary track.
Excellent.
So, you get an extra deckhand now.
I do. And I'm going to go here.
Okay. So, and I get another surefire token.
And now I can move three.
Whoop-de-doo. Now I can move three. Look at me. My name's Brittany.
You feel a little upset. That was because you moved my sugarcane. You could have avoided all of that and just given me my sugarcane. Mm-hmm. You had to stir things up.
Little darling.
That's the ripple effect.
Here you did. Give me your ripple effect. Hit your ripple effect right here.
Oh, I crossed the red line.
Oh, okay. So you got. Oh, you do have somebody next door. So you get a gold coin.
Yay.
And now I'm going to move these ships. Bam. Bam. And the Navy ship is going to take all your people away from you and put them in repair. It's going to lay the hurt down on your deckhands. Okay. It's a tight game. Tight game. Tight. It's tight. All right. So, I'm going to do a. Things through. I'm going to do a plunder. Well, I can't go into a storm because I don't have anybody to jostle, so I can't go into the. I can't plunder in there. But I will plunder because I can move two spaces. I'll plunder in here. And I'll take one token. I get, my coffee. So, all coffee. And apparently, that's all my boat carries is coffee. They're all coffee, right? It's kind of, yeah. Gonna get the light hits that middle one. Looks purple. Okay, so I plundered a coffee. I can bury a treasure chest if I had money or enough gold, but I do not, so I'm done.
Okay. I am going to trade. I'm going to move here, and I'm going to sell my rum, please. And that gives me four.
Four gold.
Okay. My go. Appreciate that you did that. I'm gonna jump all the way to trade. And now you just up the price of my coffee.
Oh.
So I'm going to move right into coffee. And I'm going to trade. Hold on. Before I go there, I was here. Just make sure I'm going to the right spot. Do I have anything? I have nothing to trade, so I'm trade. Okay. So I'm going to coffee. And again, I only need to trade two to coffee crates because the coffee is all the way at 4 again. So that's 8 for me, which would put me at 14. So I'd max out at 13. Lower the price of or the value of coffee. There you go. So, okay. I'm loaded up with cashola. And now, I think that is it for me. Yeah, nothing triggers. Okay, so I have nobody on extort. So move the ships.
Okay, so orange, black, maybe.
Okay, I'm going to lose all my characters. All right, so they all go over here, back into repair. They are familiar with this process. Okay.
Okay, so I'm going to use my deck hands, and I'm going to go around the board or the wheel and attack. And I'm going to move here, and I'm going to attack the black ship.
You're going to attack an innocent merchant ship. You're a monster.
You're
a monster.
Okay, so if you can please pass me. So I've also crossed the red line. Just want to let you know.
Yeah.
Okay. So if you could pass me the dice, please.
There you go.
Thank you.
3s and 5s.
So I am going to re-roll my 3.
Because of my ability
right here.
Baldy eye patch guy. Oh.
Another 5.
Nailed it.
So I hit for 4.
So you go up the legendary track again?
Oh, I hit for 5 because of
the. Doesn't matter. You go up the legendary track. You're done.
So I go up again, which now allows me to roll 3 dice when I attack.
Nice.
And.
You get 4 gold.
I get 4. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Oh. I think you might win this.
No.
Because I can bury your if you can bury your treasure chest in your turn, you're going to win this. If you can bury a treasure chest, that's all you have to be able to do. So.
Which I can't.
This guy's going to turn his ass around, go here, go here. The navy's going to go here, put all your guys in repair. You didn't have anybody next door, so you didn't get any gold for that.
Nope.
That's the end of that. Now it is my turn. I'm going to plunder, and for me, I can actually bury treasure on a plunder action. So, I...
Oh, so you're going to bury this turn.
Yeah. So I'm going to go here, plunder 1, which gives me a sugar cane. And as a bonus action to my plunder, I can bury a treasure chest, which I will for 13 gold in this area right here. So, as you can see, I have no more treasure chests left. Last one's played. That triggers the end of the game.
Hey.
If you can bury a treasure this turn, you win.
Yeah. So, I have to get to a place so I can bury treasure here.
Yes, you can.
Or here.
You can bury treasure on a lot of places.
And I'm going to go over to search. I'm going to move 1, 2, 3, where the black ship is.
You know this is all, you have to jostle.
Oh, the whole thing?
You have to jostle.
Okay, so I guess I'll go here.
1, 2, so you get jostled still. You want to stay
here? I'll just go here.
Oh, you want to stay here. Okay, so you
still... Because I can still...
You still get jostled.
Yes.
Because you entered it.
Correct.
Okay. So you're doing a search?
I'm going to search.
You're hoping this is gold?
Yes.
It's moved through the storm for free.
I want to know, is the black one gold?
We'll find out.
I
want to
know.
We'll find out. We can't find out now.
So I lose.
Hold on. We'll finish your turn there. So now, that was your search action.
mm-hmm. right?
Yep.
You flipped, you coin, and your bonuses, you can't bury treasure because you only have nine gold.
Yep.
You can plunder. It's not going to get you anything right now. So you can choose, you don't have to plunder. It's not going to do anything for you.
It's not going to, nothing's, yep.
You can switch tokens. Yeah, you have nothing that'll help you right now.
I have nothing that I can do. I lose.
Oh.
Good game. Can you check under the black ship to see it? Because that's where I originally wanted to go.
Okay, so you wanted to go all the way over here to check this one.
Yeah.
And you're hoping that this was at least...
Three
gold. If this was three gold, you couldn't have buried it here. Because you need 13 to bury here.
Oh, that's not a...
So it wouldn't have mattered. I know what you're hoping you got here and that got me.
I could have gone here.
You couldn't have made it all the way over there.
Yeah, I could have.
One, two, three, four spaces. How much can you move? Three.
Oh, three.
Do you want to know what this is anyways?
Yeah. Okay, I lost.
Even if it was three coins, you couldn't have done it.
What? Why?
Because it's not a storm area. Three coins would have given you 12.
Oh, yeah. Shoot. Okay.
If you found three coins here...
I've lost. Stop rubbing it in.
Three coins there would have gotten you the win. All right, well, that was a good game. Especially good because I won. Good game, Brittany. Good game. Arr! Yeah, good pirate. A good pirate. All right, well, Brittany just walked the plank.
I'm so sad.
Okay, so that was it. That was the game. That was Tiny Epic Pirates. I enjoy playing this. Brittany, what do you think?
I like it, too. I do like in this game that it kind of swings, where you think that, you know, you may be losing and you don't have a chance, and then all of a sudden something happens in a couple
I find turns. Every game we've had so far has
been... really
close. It's been just like that, where it looks like, well, Brittany's way in the lead. Yesterday's game we had, you were a huge lead.
Yeah.
And then I came and just won because I was like trading everything at max. Like all the booty I got was like five gold.
And you won. You crushed me.
Yeah. So it was like your buried treasures came to a halt.
Yeah.
And then my strategy came into effect.
Yeah.
But Brittany was doing good by going up on the legendary track, because if we tied, which we normally tie.
Yeah, we do.
As in...
I would have won.
Not tie. We've tied once, actual tie, where we shared the victory. But usually we tie, and then we have to go through the tiebreaker thing, which is first person highest on the legendary track. And then after that, if you're tied on the legendary track, you base it on your money. And Brittany usually beats me because she has like one coin. but that's it. That was good.
That was it.
I've been enjoying this.
I want to play again.
All right. Well, thanks for joining us, guys. This was a good time. If you're interested, I'm not sure when this video is going to go up, but this might still be on Kickstarter. If not, the gambling guys usually have a late pledge option. So yeah, if you liked what you saw, you would get this and a prettier version. Oh, and they also have their expansion pack, which looks like, I forget what it's called, but it's got like haunted ships and clear cubes. It looks cool. It looks cool. I want to play with the expansion. All right, that is it. Thanks for joining us. We will see you next week with who knows what we'll be doing next.
Yeah, and let us know in the comments below if you enjoyed this video, if you backed the Kickstarter.
Or if you saw any mistakes, let us know.
Yeah, let us know.
Because mistakes happen. They happen. We can't change it now, but let us know.
Okay.
All right. Bye. See you guys. Thanks for joining us. If you like this video and you want to see more, subscribe to our channel. It's the best way to keep up to date with everything we do here at Board Game Coffee. But if you want to see more right now, we got plenty of videos to choose from. And if that's not enough, follow us on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. I'm Mark Maya, and this is Board Game Coffee. And remember, have fun, keep gaming, be social. See you next week.